Hello everyone, myself Saurav Upadhyay. I am going to present a very detailed analysis of the engineering mathematics paper that came in the forenoon and afternoon session of the civil engineering branch. Before I start my analysis about the paper, I want you students to write in the comment section that what do you think about the paper, about the entire paper, right? Also, I request the other branches students to go through the entire session so that it will give you a bit of idea about what you may face in the engineering maths paper, right? I'll not drop any conclusion as of now. What do I feel about the paper? I'll be solving the questions that whatever I've received from my fellow mates. After that, we will make some of the other conclusions about the paper, right? No need to worry about the MSQ questions, as there I didn't find anyone, and I hope that you also didn't find many MSQ questions, at least in the maths paper, right? Let's start with the forenoon session questions. Now, this was a limit question that came in the forenoon session. What do you think about the question? Now, everyone knows that in any limit question, the first thing is what? We determine its form. If you see, the form is, if you put 1 by ln ln of 1, 0 minus 1 by, you know, 1 minus 1, 0, it's clearly infinite minus infinite form, right? In infinite minus infinite form, we convert it in 0 by 0 or infinite by infinite form. How? By taking the LCM. So what I'll do is, I will quickly take its LCM. It is x minus 1 minus ln x divided by x minus 1 into ln x, right? You will see that if you put substitute 1 in the entire form, it is 1 minus 1 means it is of the form, I guess, 0 by 0, right? Ln of 1, 0, 1 minus 1, 0. What after that? It's L'Hopital's rule. Clearly, the entire purpose was to convert it in a form where we can use L'Hopital's rule, right? So, differentiate the numerator and denominator. What? It is 1 minus 0 minus 1 by x divided by, here I'll be using product rule, so it is x minus 1 into ln x differentiation is 1 by x plus ln x into 1. So let me rearrange it. It is 1 minus 1 by x divided by what it is, it is 1 minus 1 by x plus ln of x, right? If I again check its form, it will be, if I substitute, it will be 1 minus 1, 0, 0, 0, so it's again 0 by 0 form. Again, we can apply L'Hopital's rule. If you again apply L'Hopital's rule, it will be limit extending to 1, minus 1 by x differentiation is 1 by x square divided by constant integration 0, differentiation 0, then again it is 1 by x square plus ln x differentiation is 1 by x, right? If you finally substitute 1, it will be 1 by 1, 1 by 1 plus 1, or it is coming out to be 0.5. So, we are getting 0.5 as the answer. I hope that you have solved this question correctly because everything was predetermined. Please let me know that whether you have solved this question correctly or not. And also, if this is an NAT question, you have strictly followed the correct decimal places that they have mentioned. Fine. Let's go to the next question. The next question is, a matrix have been given, 4 by 4 given, and you need to find its rank. Let me write the matrix. 4 by 4 matrix, everyone knows that we need to apply, we need to convert this matrix into row echelon form. Yes, row echelon form, pretty easy, right? It's a 4 by 4 matrix. What I'll do, I'll try to make these elements as 0. I hope that everyone knows row echelon form, right? So, wait, just a minute. Now, what operations can I use? I will try to make these elements as 0. So, it is R2 tending to R2 minus 3R1. I'll be writing all the operations all together. R3 is R3 minus 5R1, R 2, 3, 4, this is 4, is R4 minus 7 times of R1. If I use all these operations all together, these elements will be 0, and accordingly means all the operations will be applied to these rows as well. Now I am directly writing the matrix. What is my transformed matrix? The transformed matrix is, wait, I've solved it, so let me write it directly. It is 1, 2, 2, 3, and this will be 0, 0, 0. Again it will be minus 2, minus 4, minus 4. Again it is minus 4, minus 8, minus 8, minus 6, minus 12, minus 12. Right? Clearly you can see that these two rows are dependent on this row. Right? Isn't it? If you multiply by 2 in this row, you will get this row, the third row. And if you multiply by 3 in the second row, you will be getting the fourth row. So clearly you can see, although I'm writing the operations that R3 is equal to R3 minus 2 times of R2, and R4 is equal to R4 minus 3 times of R2. If you use these two operations directly, your third and fourth row will get 0. It's not even needed to check individual elements. You can clearly find out, right? So clearly this is 1, 2, 2, 3, 0, minus 2, minus 4, minus 4, and you can make all these elements as 0. So how many non-zero rows you can find in the row echelon form? The number of non-zero rows is 1 and 2. Obviously these two are not dependent on each other. So its rank is coming out to be 2. Rank is coming out to be 2. So I hope that you have solved this question correctly. There is a very less chance of making a silly mistake over here, right? Everything is so direct. The question is so direct and so simple, right? So I hope that you have got this correct as well. Fine. Let's move on to the next question. For the next question, again, two matrices were given, 2 by 2, 2 cross 2 matrices were given, and it was a direct question was asked. Let me write. I guess this is a one mark question. It was given that, this was the question that I have received, and now you can see this is a pretty simple question. Directly write this as Q of t is what? Q of t is 0, 1, 1, 0, and R of t is 1, 2, 3, 4, right? And if you multiply it, I hope you know the method. We multiply in an inverted L fashion. Is what? 0 plus 2, again it is 0 into 3, 0 plus 4, again it is what? 1 into 1 plus 0, and it is what? 1 into 3, 3 plus 0, and the final matrix you are getting is 2, 4, 1 and 3. I hope this is the answer that you have got too. It's a pretty simple question. No need of worrying as well. I'm sure that you are getting this one at least right. So let me tell you that if you're finding this session as useful, please do like and subscribe, and please do let me know that which of the questions have you got correct and what do you feel about the entire session, right?